Welcome to the project demonstration of face recognition system based attendance system. So, and also SMS alerts for the absent students. So here we are going to detect the multiple face recognition system from camera. So in order to make the data set for the students, just here we need to open these three files: collector.image, main.m, and the take image predict. And now go to collect image, and here we need to just copy the name, the function, and paste in the command window, and also in that parenthesis folder write the first name. So this is going to be the student IDs 1, 2, 3, 4. Now we are naming the students as a 1, 2, 3, 4, and now just click on run. So once click on that, so you can see the command window, the program get executing, and the camera will be open. So it will take 20 snaps. So just place a face. It will take the 20 snaps. This of 20 images, you can see the particular images continuously capturing here. So for different face features, it will provide the different image sets. So total data set will be stored and captured around of 20 samples. Okay, and it's very important. Now once the 20 samples created, and the window will be closed automatically. And now we need to copy this 20 images, cut them directly, and go to data set and go to the one folder and save them. That's it. So one work was done, and coming to the next student, and just press up arrow. So just enter the 2, and now before running that, the person should sit in front of this camera. And just hit enter. The second user face will be captured. So we can observe the same 20 images will be captured and will be stored in the same folder. Right. Now same, we need to repeat the same step for second student also. Just go to the same folder and now cut the images. And paste them in folder number 2. Folder number 3, same student 3 also. So once it was done, and now go to the main. Sorry, go to the take image predict.m. So here we need to enter one COM number. So now we need to connect the our kit. So coming to this kit, so we interface the LCD module along with GSM modem to the Arduino Uno. And so we need to insert a valid SIM card inside this. We need to provide the two power supplies. So one is a main power supply for the kit, and another is from the USB power supply. So once, just before switching on this power supply to the GSM modem, in order to get the COM number, just connect the Arduino to your PC, a laptop, and then go to my this PC and a manager. And there we'll get the device manager, and from there we'll get the communication pin number, COM number. So directly, right? So here the device manager. So click on the device manager. So as of now, the kit connected to the laptop. So there we will get the COM number. So here the COM number is, we can see the COM number is 17, right? Note down this COM number, this is very important. So after note down the COM number, you can disconnect the Arduino Uno now, as of now. Right, as of now, just I'm disconnecting the, and you can see that the COM number was disconnected. If I connect again, so you get the COM number. So this particular COM number will be fixed for respective USB ports or USB slots in your laptop. Just enter the COM number at this line. So this line number 7, and only that change has to be modified inside take image predict.m, and then go to main M and stay there. Now coming to the next setup to the kit again. So insert the valid SIM card inside the GSM modem. It should be properly inserted, and it should be message balance, valid SIM, and other than Jio, Airtel, VI, BSNL is okay. And now just give the power supply, switch on the kit, then there will be a welcome message, and at this section hold this reset switch, press and hold it till you can see one green light is blinking very fast. Now it is slow down, right? When it blinks at 3 seconds of duration, then only we need to release the button, because when it gets the signal, it will indicate it through the LED of 3 seconds of duration, and then only the Arduino can communicate and it can enable the GSM modem to send the messages. Now release that, you can see welcome message, and this kit will take the attendance till 1 minute. As of the demonstration purpose, we placed in 60 seconds, right? Now it's started, and now we are going to run this code, right? So as of now, then we need to connect the USB slot also, and after connected, so very important is, once first we need to give the power supply to the GSM modem to hold the kit and wait the till you get the signal to the GSM modem, and then connect the kit to the Arduino Uno. And now it is connected, you can see the particular COM number again here. So that is connected, COM 17, and now run main.m, and whenever the first image detected, we can, I'll show you. So student one present, so it will take a booting setup in the command window. We can see that we need to set all these things, right? So the camera got started. So that it's open. So we can see that one is showing over there. So when it is showing one on this laptop, so you can see here the student one present. Just I restarted to make the time zero. Right, student one present, because it's entered. Now let us see the first student number two. Done. So you can see it will show you the student number 2 here. Okay, student number 2 is present here. So you can see that student number 2 present. So after 60 seconds of duration, it will show that we place the two images for the student number 2 and 3. So for demonstration purpose, once the 60 seconds completed, it will check the attendance and it will display the how many students are present and how many students are absent. Now ending attendance and checking, all present, because we placed the student, and now I kept the only one student, student 2 and 3, right? Because I placed this madam image, and now student 2 and 3 are present, student 1 is absent. So now the particular parent will receive the message. So wait till the 60 seconds, I'll hold the camera. So now 60 seconds completed and checking attendance, and like 1 is absent, 2 and 3 is present, and now it will send the message to the first student parent, and this will receive the message. So you can see that, so this is a message, student 1 is absent. Thank you.